Pauline Hanson has hinted she'll have another tilt at politics despite her failed bid for a spot in state parliament.
She polled the strongest personal vote in the upper house ballot but was beaten on preferences by the Greens.
She arrived for the final count hopeful, even greeting well wishes in the Electoral Commission's car park.
Confident but not overconfident. So we'll see what happens.
Inside, the calculation of preferences that would decide her fate began at 11. A nervous Miss Hanson looked on for 40 minutes as the winning 21 upper house candidates started to appear. She wasn't one of them. After 2.5 weeks of counting and a lifetime of controversy, her political hopes were once again dashed.
Is this the end of your political ambitions?
Look, I'm just going to sit back and take a look at this because I can't disregard the votes that I got.
She polled 25% better than her 2003 election result and believes informal votes may have cost her the spot. And despite her rocky history in the media spotlight, she may well run again or establish another party.
You need me around to keep the bastards honest, don't you? So.
But for every loser, there is a winner. And in this case, it was the Greens, victorious in claiming their third upper house seat and their first MP to hail from west of the Great Divide.
It's all very new for Jeremy Buckingham, the Green from Orange, who hopes to stand up for the country.
I seek to raise their issues in the New South Wales Parliament over the coming eight years.
As for Pauline Hanson, she's going fishing near her new home at Port Stephens.
I did drive down. I didn't come by boat, and this is my home.
Josh Murphy, 10 News.